All right, so it did something. It did this to me the last time. Here's the original bridge I had for it. I had to make a second bridge the second time around because see how high it went? It seems like when I glue it with the heat gun, the net pops up. I guess the extra glue in between, and then when you bring it to, like, I mean, the thing seems solid already. So maybe last time I didn't have the glue gun quite as. But look at how high that is. I think what it is that there's probably needed to be shimmed between the button and the neck joint. And that's why when you put the glue in, it pops it that way because the glue's in the pocket. I mean, it's, you know, relatively straight for where it's supposed to be. So I'm good that way. It just sits the fingerboard sitting up so high. That said, you know, you could live with it. But it already seems like it's, like, in there pretty good. So, I'm not even going to bother clamping it. I think the clamp pushes the neck back a bit. And, then, well, it's too late now. But the hot glue's already taking its toll. So, well, we'll see. I doubt it's going to hold for very long. But at least, you know, it's something. I probably won't wait the full month because to see, because I have a hunch it's probably going to pop apart again. Yeah, see, that's the original bridge. I made another bridge the first time I glued it back together. For whatever reason, I didn't put too much glue in there this time, but yet it seems to, I guess when I clamp it, it pops it out to keep it to the button. So there is, I guess, a gap between the button and the neck, and that's what pops it up. But, I mean, if it plays, it plays. And if it played and sound fine like this. It just, people will mock it for saying, look, you could fit a giraffe under there. Okay, so, is what it is. You know, is what it is. So I'll just wait, and we'll... But that hot glue seemed to work really good this time. I maybe last time I didn't wait for the gun long enough to get hot enough. I gave it about 15 minutes. But it's nice to see it back together, isn't it, eh? Isn't that nice? Let's go outside and look at it. I won't play around with it too much. But yeah, I think my issue, the next time it comes apart, if it comes apart, hopefully it never does. Well, in a way, if it does, it's okay. I mean, it's not like the end of the world. Sorry, my hand is blocking all the beauty from you. I shouldn't be moving this around too much because I definitely don't want to. Look at that. Look at that. Let's get in the sun. Ready? Ready? Oh, look at that. Now you see why I want to preserve this violin. Isn't it just gorgeous? Yeah. Well, there's no light showing between the, there's a little bit of a gap there, so, yeah, I guess the glue's thick enough that it, pops up the fingerboard, so, please don't mock my fingerboard. Look at the height of that. You're that 747, he could pass between there. Okay, well, fixed is fixed, right? Hey, patch it now, fix it later, eh, Gazoo? Well, we fixed it. Just hopefully it'll settle. Like the neck angle's good. I wonder if maybe next time if I just take the actual heel joint down by, say, well, that's probably over an inch, so I'd have to take it down quite a bit here. Weird how it worked out like that, because like I say, when it was drying before I put the glue to it, I mean, it sat there perfectly. I was like, okay, that's good. But I guess the glue is just thick enough, like I say, to pop out this, you know, just a little bit, and then there was probably, yeah, see, there's a little bit of a light between the button, but I don't want to, you never want to pressure the button at all, so it's not a perfect fit, so I'll have to refit it again next time.
Compensate
for the glue, so maybe I'll leave it about a week and a half. I should leave it for a month, but it's just, my hunch is, see my nice violins here. Including my beautiful lion head violin over there. That one If I ever get the proper fish glue, that stuff is as close to fish glue as possible. And hide glue. Maybe it was a heat problem I had. I've got the other bridges. I've got a bunch of bridges here. I got to figure out which one was the one I put on there. I think it was that one there. So I'll figure that out. And shop around when you're hunting for bridges for your violin, because I got these ones for $8 a piece. At some of the other violin shops, they wanted 50 a piece. Exact same bridge, same maker, everything. So watch out for that. Yeah, so just give you an idea. I don't know if you can see the other violins. You can see the gap there is pretty good, but yeah, on the Procop. Mind you, the Procop is not a normal violin. This is what you would call a normal 1713 Stradivari, Stradivarius copy. And I'll put the violin right beside is a 3/4, so we're not going to, that's a total different animal here. This is a nice little violin. I am going to sell it, I think, but it's a nice sweet sounding one. But here's what I'm talking about. Okay, there's the ginormous Hornsteiner. You could beat people up with this thing. This thing is just a sound monster and a half. I love it. There. So right beside the Stradivari, like, you can see very clearly the size differences. Like, the thicknesses are about the same, but Procop, I guess he wanted more of a sound chamber. I mean, that's probably a good, well, let's see. See, we can kind of straight edge these things there. I don't want to play around with that too much right now. But, yeah, we'll use a boat manual as a straight edge. Like, that's like almost half inch longer in the body. The width, say, yeah, about 1/4 inch wider. Thickness is about the same. But look at the fingerboard differences. Both fingerboards are sitting roughly about the same spot. And that comes out about an extra half inch. So, I mean, so maybe the sitting up high like that is the way Procop designed. Again, 1920, made by hand tools. You know what I mean? Like, it, you know, they're all, not all going to be exact and, you know, factor in the year. Plus, once you put the strings on it too, that fingerboard does come back, you know, under tension. You know, the violins will bow. I mean, even this one, you know, is the fingerboard's actually almost too low on this one. But I mean, it's a variation, right? So with the string tension on it, you take the string tension off of that, that's going to come up, you know, it's going to, you know, the neck's going to lean back a bit more. So, you know, they're all going to be slightly different. Again, being so old. So this one, like, see, this one has a lot of tension going back on the neck. So this one's a bit higher. Maybe don't hit the drawing. This one, again, this big fat girl here, my lion head. I love this violin so much. You know, it's a little bit higher than that one and that one. So, they, you know, they vary. There's a variation. At the end of the day, it doesn't really make that much of a difference. I mean, if it's in a show where you're judging the violin by the craftsman and all that, okay, yeah, I can understand there it would make a difference. Let's have a look at this one. I never really looked at this one. See, this one, yeah, it's up there pretty good too. Not the same though. Like, I mean, that's definitely a gap. So I think that's just the way, it's the only way the neck's going to settle on there. And then again, once the tension's on it, it probably comes down a bit. So yeah, there's that. But oh geez, it's so nice to see it together. I can't wait to string it up and play this one. I was just about to string it up and play it for you guys the last time I glued it together, and I just got it up to pitch and the whole thing just went boom, all four strings at the same time, it just folded. So if it does that again, why not? You know, like, I mean, it's a quick fix. Could be a permanent fix, maybe. Like I say, the hot glue should go into the wood pores and that should hold it. And it's not like you know, the glue should, you know, it should hold, like, even, okay, it's not necessarily the proper glue, but with a, you know, hot glue like that should hold. I mean, the temperature's roughly around the same temperature, you know, 50, 60 degrees or 80 degrees, whatever they heat the glue up to, whether it's high glue, fish glue, whichever, you know, it should be about the same there. So you would think it's going to have the same kind of properties. Maybe the glue itself is just a softer glue that, you know, allows it to flex. And once it flexes, then whatever. But we'll see. We'll see. But the joint seems really solid this time. I mean, the heat of the glue seems like I just got the right amount on there that it probably just, you know, is bonding and drying at the same time because it's so hot. And it seems like the neck joint, like I couldn't move it at all. Like it wasn't, okay, it's kind of squishy and it's going to go into place. That's what happened last time. So I think last time I didn't get the heat, the glue gun quite up to the heat I wanted it. This time it should be good. So maybe that was the trick. Maybe I just didn't have the heat at the right thing. But yeah, we'll come back to it. And there we go. Violin repaired-ish for now. Soon to be strung up and making sound again. I will get downstairs where there's more light again. So that project I've been dying to get to. And kind of glad that things didn't work out the other way today so that I could get to that project. And then, you know, my cat, he wasn't much of a help because he just lies there and does nothing. What do you think about the violin being fixed? You don't even care, do you? Not even close, right? Unless it involves treats. Treats? Is that what it's all about? Am I keeping you up good, sir? I mean, poor guy only got 23 hours of sleep last night. I should go easy on him, you know what I mean? There we go. So the glue gun, just leaving it there. Make sure you always unplug those things. Bit of a mess on the table here, but yeah, so I'm happy to get that done. Very happy to get that done. So, and now I patiently wait. While I'm waiting, damn it, girl.